This is the tallest abandoned building in the world. At 597 meters, it towers higher than the Shanghai World Financial Center, higher than the Petronas Towers, and higher than nearly every skyscraper on the planet. In fact, it's the sixth tallest skyscraper in the world. And yet, for nearly a decade, it stood unfinished. A ghostly concrete skeleton looming over the city of Tianjin, China. So how did a building designed to be one of the most luxurious skyscrapers in Asia turn into the world's tallest ruin? And more importantly, why is construction starting again after all these years? To understand this tower, we need to step back to the early 2000s. China was going through the largest urban migration in human history. Millions were moving from the countryside into rapidly growing cities. Places like Tianjin, just 30 minutes from Beijing by high-speed train, were exploding in population and wealth. Developers saw opportunity everywhere, and one of them was Pan Sutong, a billionaire who built his fortune in electronics and real estate. In 2008, Pan launched his most ambitious project yet, the Goldin Metropolitan, a $10 billion master plan that included luxury homes, a polo club, a winery, and at the center of it all, Goldin Finance 117. This skyscraper wasn't just another tall building. At 128 floors, it was designed to be a statement piece. Offices, a six-star hotel, and at the very top, a diamond-shaped crown with a sky lobby and observation deck. For Tianjin, it was meant to symbolize progress. For Pan Sutong, it was meant to prove he could compete with the world's elite developers. Building a 597-meter skyscraper is no simple feat. Goldin Finance 117 was designed with a reinforced concrete core, surrounded by massive steel columns, and supported by an outrigger and belt truss system for stability. This gave the structure both strength and flexibility, essential for a tower this tall. The foundations were equally impressive. Engineers drilled deep piles into bedrock, securing the tower on ground that was otherwise soft and unstable. Wind, of course, was another challenge. At nearly 600 meters, the building would sway in storms. To prevent this, engineers used aerodynamic shaping and ran detailed wind tunnel tests, minimizing how much the structure could bend. Inside, the tower was planned to have over 80 high-speed elevators, capable of reaching speeds of 36 kilometers per hour, some of the fastest in the world. It was meant to combine luxury with cutting-edge engineering, joining the ranks of the Burj Khalifa in Dubai and Shanghai Tower in China. But no amount of engineering can save a project when the money dries up. By 2015, construction suddenly stopped, not because of technical issues, but because of a financial collapse. The Goldin Metropolitan project had been largely self-financed. Pan Sutong poured billions of his own money into the development. At first, this worked. China's property market seemed unstoppable. But then, reality hit. The 2015 Chinese stock market crash wiped out fortunes overnight. On top of that, the Tianjin port explosions that same year, one of the largest industrial accidents in history, shook investor confidence and the local economy. For Pan Sutong, the impact was devastating. His personal fortune dropped by more than $13 billion. Goldin Properties, his real estate arm, was drowning in debt. By December 2015, work on Goldin Finance 117 had stopped completely. The giant tower, already one of the tallest structures in the world, was left unfinished. A massive, hollow skyscraper with no completed interior. Locals began calling it a ghost skyscraper. Even abandoned, the tower couldn't be ignored. With its sheer height and diamond-shaped crown, locals gave it a nickname, the walking stick. But the building also became a symbol of something larger. China had been building more skyscrapers than any other country on Earth, sometimes faster than cities could actually fill them. For many, Goldin Finance 117 came to represent the excesses of China's real estate boom, ambitious, overscaled, and unsustainable. For Tianjin, It was both a point of pride and a constant reminder of failure. A structure that should have drawn the world's attention ended up standing as an embarrassment. For years, the skyscraper sat untouched. Concrete exposed, glass never installed, cranes removed from the site. But in May 2025, something changed. After a decade of abandonment, construction resumed. The project is now under P&T Group, a Hong Kong-based architecture firm, and BGI Engineering, one of China's major contractors. Reports suggest the restart is likely backed by state support. The plan? To finally complete the skyscraper by 2027. Of course, after sitting exposed for so long, the building isn't simply ready to pick up where it left off. Engineers have to retrofit the structure, re-inspecting every beam and column, testing the integrity of the concrete, and updating outdated systems. Elevators, electrical wiring, plumbing, everything must be modernized to meet current safety standards. There's also talk of a potential redesign. Originally planned as a hotel and office tower, the building could be partially converted into residential use, reflecting shifts in demand. So why restart now? Part of it comes down to image. Letting one of the tallest skyscrapers in the world rot away forever would send the wrong message. Completing it gives Tianjin a global landmark and erases an embarrassing chapter. It's also about China's evolving real estate market. After years of overbuilding, many cities are slowing down on new skyscrapers. But finishing an existing one, especially one this iconic, makes more sense than starting fresh. And at 597 meters, Goldin Finance 117 is still an engineering marvel, nearly as tall as the Burj Khalifa. If completed, it will finally join the ranks of the world's super tall skyscrapers instead of being known as the tallest ruin. The story of Goldin Finance 117 is one of ambition, collapse, and revival. What began as a symbol of Tianjin's economic rise turned into a warning sign of China's overextended property market. For nearly 10 years, it stood frozen in time, a ghostly monument to overconfidence. Now, with construction restarting, it has the chance to become what it was always meant to be, a centerpiece of Tianjin's skyline. Will it succeed this time? Or will the challenges of finishing such a massive project once again prove too much? One thing is certain. Goldin Finance 117 will always be remembered, not just for its size, but for the story behind it. So let's recap. Goldin Finance 117 was launched in 2008 as the centerpiece of a $10 billion mega development. At 597 meters, it became the tallest abandoned building in the world after construction stopped in 2015 due to financial collapse. For a decade, it stood as a ghostly monument to China's real estate boom and bust. But in 2025, construction resumed, with plans to finally complete the skyscraper by 2027, giving Tianjin the landmark it was promised almost 20 years ago. So what do you think? Will Goldin Finance 117 finally be finished? Or is it destined to remain the world's tallest ghost tower? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell for more stories about the world's biggest and most fascinating megastructures.